I had used my last,
What, breathing?
Lessons, yes, training, for everything but childbirth.
Yeah.
I remember when my son fell and snapped both of the bones of his wrist, he was like in and out of consciousness, and I'm like, breathe with me, and I'm like doing the breathing.
Yeah.
Jim looks over at me, my husband, he goes, why does that seem so familiar? I said, because I was not in my mom's classes, you moron.
Oh my God.
Did you guys do it in childbirth?
What's that?
Did you guys use it during childbirth?
Not really, because apparently I was built to have babies.
Oh, wow.
So, oh yeah, I was like a legend at Northwest Medical Center.
Wow.
You want to see what I met too? And I think I pushed 3 times.
I was not that at
all. Out came a 9.5-pound baby. The doctor looked at him and he says, remember when I told your buddy about 7.5-8 pounds? I'm like, he's definitely over 9. I'm like, I knew he was bigger than you said. This kid's been on my bladder for 6 months.
Nah.
Yeah, 9 pounds in the bladder.
Chelsea was like, yeah, I'm coming. No, I'm not. Yeah, I'm coming. No, I'm not.
And my second one, I was being born to myself.
Yeah.
His little feet, she kept telling me to stop pushing. I'm like, I can feel his feet under my ribs. Like, each contraction,
pushing
he's pushing.
Out.
Hey.
Because they couldn't get, Northwest was undergoing renovations at the time. And they couldn't get him on they couldn't find him here. Because the case system wasn't
working.
And then she's like, my nurse, or my doctor, my OB is on the phone with some old lady that was the docent down at the visitor thing at the front desk. And she's like, do not make me come down there. She's this man is going to miss the birth of his child. You get your ass in that cafeteria and you go find, he's a bald guy with a baseball cap and a toe-head little boy with him. You can't miss him. It's not that busy.
Oh, she
comes running up and bursts through the door. And I'm like, good thing you're here.
Yeah.
One
you caught 1 minute. Yeah, half minute.
OD. I started having troubles, like she'd come down and she'd go, what is going on? Are you going to do this? I started attacking her. Are you going to do this?
Oh, wow. That's messed up.
I didn't even know why I had to have her to go back. Well, I was last time. I had to have her.
That was what I had for my first kid, so this is actually a So, my first OB was a man, the second one and the third one were both women, but he was a man. So, all of my family is New Jersey, my mom's family, the whole extended family.
Uh-huh.
So, my mother comes out for the baby,
goes
back, and of course, this is her first grandchild, so like she has 5 gazillion pictures to show everybody when she goes visiting. So, one of her cousins is sitting there and she's looking through the pictures of the day he was born. And here's this man in the pictures with me, big old smile on his face.
Too.
And my mother's like, isn't he just a beautiful baby? And my cousin's like, yeah. And so my mom started to get pissed because the more pictures she's looking at, the more my mom's getting mad because she's not gushing about my mother's beautiful grandson, right? So my mother's like, what's your problem? She's like, oh, I didn't realize that my doctor was. His last name was Harris.
Oh, no!
Yeah.
How odd is that?
Right?
Yeah.
So there's
scary.
About 15 minutes
there's
and
like
my extended family.
Story.
I'm like, y'all saw pictures of my husband. Like,
that's
he's whiter than me.
Well, if the baby would have came out black, it would have been really.
Oh, right.
Yeah, then we would have had to have some conversation.
We would have had some serious combos.
But what made it funnier to me was that when Jim first got out of the Air Force, he used to get all of these, advertisements and stuff in the mail from the NAACP and the United Negro College Fund. And I'm like, why would they do that? Because it's just, they're just going by the name Harris. Like, there's plenty of white people in Harris.
Oh,
you don't have to be, you know, African American to have that.
No.
I told them, I said, you should just take their money and open a business. Like, they're going to throw it at you. And then if you say something to you, they're going to be racist.
Oh, my God.
Yeah. Yeah, he didn't want to get into that. I would have done it. I almost did, actually. My first husband was Hispanic.
Uh-huh.
And so after we got divorced, I started getting all these things from La Raza Tulsa and Tacoma's Public Tulsa to find we'd love to help Hispanic women start their own businesses.
Okay.
I just couldn't think of a business to start. That was my problem.
Well, once I did,
but I would have been all over it if I had come up with something.
Exactly. Wow.
I'm like, you know what? You want to throw money on it and not qualify your potential recipients.
Exactly. Go for it. Look at this guy now. He's like, this is not, I kind of want to take off all this stuff, you know, just to get the good brushing. Look at this.
Look at this. You're just so happy to be out of that horrible isolation kennel, huh, bud? I'm not even sure he was all that sick. I felt so bad.
For this guy?
Yeah.
Fletch?
But he was the one that was coughing that day, right? And then Hawthorne was sneezing like crazy. I think that's what it was. He was coughing.
Yeah.
That's what it was. Because his cough sounded like... So Thursday he had a... Friday it was and by Saturday it was... that kennel cough, that really deep, deep...
Because allergies are running thick, you know. It's just
well, that's why I didn't say anything. Plus, they had all gotten their shots for the chlamydia when the strep outbreak started again. It's a
Convenia. Okay.
Convenia.
Okay.
It's what they use to. It's a one shot instead of having to medicate dogs twice a day, every day for like 10 days straight for strep.
Just a shot.
It's a one and done shot. Nice. But he had gotten the shot, and then 2 days later, both him and Hawthorne broke with upper respiratory infection symptoms. I'm like, that doesn't make sense.
Well,
you're supposed to do the opposite of that. I even sent an email to Dr. Wilcox. I'm like, did you give him a shot to get sick? Because it seems like they're all dropping with kennel because these two ended up with getting sick. So over the space of 4 days, I had 4 dogs from here, but they weren't all here at the same time, so it couldn't have even been from that.
Yeah. Well, I wonder if given the shot after, Ellie, you know this, like if you already had this, the incubation period, and then you gave the shot, is it going to, you know, kill it?
Yeah, I don't know that.
I don't know how it works. I don't know anything about this particular drug. They've only been using it for a couple of years. I think it's still pretty new, at least maybe in for this use.
I know. The doctor I worked for, like, she used it quite a bit, and, I don't
think it's as effective in a shelter environment just because of their stress levels and it's suppressing their immune systems. I really think that's got more to do with it than anything.
Yeah, sure. So.
They've been living outside for a while. He reminds me so much of me because he just uses himself. Yeah. He's so creepy.
His side.
For June weight. Oh. Yeah, I found one in the back.
I remember we found that. I had it a year ago, and then I don't know.
Yeah, I got packed with other stuff, and of course, you know, I found it 3 days after June weight wasn't here anymore.
Thank you.
here, I'll do it myself. We could do that, or we could even wait until the other, the place that's open right across, that's right at the very end here.
Yeah.
Is it called Crane?
Redbird.
He's the, he was the GM at Farber's.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Really?
And they should be, they've got to be pretty damn close to me right all that.
It's not with this contractor, this guy's.
Yeah, it's terrible.
I mean, if it looks close. Hey, I like that. Because I like fireworks. Stop it.
You are not right in the head, dude. Don't. Hey. Remember this? Lassie, what's up with you today, pretty girl? You're not very, like, happy and...
Well, there's somebody in here with me. She's not even paying any attention to me.
She's not giving any love at all.
No, I already brushed you. You got your brush in. You're just much easier to brush.
I don't know. She got back up here and they still get kisses and smile like that and okay, whatever. It's like, oh. I know you're doing so much better.
They don't get me.
Yeah, so they lived in the backyard for at least the last 2 years and the owner was her owner died. His sister is the executor of the state and knew that the animals were there, but that there were neighborhood people that were taking care of them. So and she lived there, but she wasn't his. There's a young lady that apparently is on the spectrum and has quite a lot of issues because when the police called and had a conversation with her on the phone about the dog, she's very, very hard to understand. And so what they're surmising is that she wasn't allowed to have the dog wherever she is, where she's living, and so she was living like this property. There was the two of them, a cat and a black cocker spaniel. As soon as the cocker spaniel arrived at the cat, he was put on reserve, or put him on reserve, and came and picked him up. So these two have been together for at least a couple of years. I think she does better with her. Like, I think she last is kind of a clutch, you know? So, but she's starting to come out of the show a little bit more. Theory is that if they're here with us during the busiest adoption days they have, then they're less likely to just pull up. But I think even Regina now, if they did get split up, she's come so far.
Yeah.
She, in the beginning, she was really aloof. She wouldn't really interact with people at all. This little goofy one would come right up to you and give you kisses and stuff, but now she does too. So I think now if they get split, I think Regina would be fine. My worry before is she was just going to disappear into a sea of pity-like dogs at back.
Yeah.
So,
I'm kind of surprised we're still here. Because there was a lot of dogs, but.
I think somebody should take the both of them just because they're built-in playmates for each other. Because that one's going to get herself in trouble if she has nobody to play with.
Mm-hmm.
This one I think would be fine. She would adjust to it. But this one, she's still a baby. She needs.
She needs to play.
Yeah. She needs that.
Plus she.
Maybe we should get submitted to her.
That would be awesome. Oh, yeah.
I just hate cutting clumsy. It makes me so nervous. Especially when it's like, you know, it goes to the skin. And you're so worried about where that mat. Please don't let me be cutting any skin.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah. You'll hear about it pretty quick, I'm sure. She's very patient, but I mean, she's...
she's